Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Part 2, the final sketch before the prototype. I wanted to do one final sketch rendering before I began the prototype so I could just nail down all the details. I start the sketch using an orange pen. It's sort of like using a very light gray marker. It's not black, and it allows me to just sort of ghost in and work out the details, work on the perspective, get everything nailed down. I can come in with a darker black or a purple or something like that later and darken up the darks and make this thing punchy. But for right now, using an orange pen allows me to just shade and work everything in. Here, I'm just darkening the edges of the petals, giving them some thickness, working out the details. I'm all set with the basic details, and I'm going to lay in some of the values. Here I'm putting in the ground shadow. I'm using a 20% gray, and I can build up the value of the marker. So I always start light to dark with my gray values to build up that value, and then I go darker progressively as the sketch moves on. Next, I move into a 30% gray. Again, gradually building up the values, starting to punch up the sketch, increase that contrast, make the forms read. Here I'm using a 40% gray. Again, just building up the values, adding a little bit of contrast here and there, detail. Now I'm going to move into a 50% gray and add the shadow at the bottom. This is the race area where the wire gets wrapped around, a little bit of cable management. I'm using probably an 80% gray here for the actual solar panel, much darker. And I'm coming in, adding in the hinges, and I'm using a red pen. The red pen is a little bit darker than the orange, allowing me to get a little bit more contrast and a little bit more read in some of the detail areas. Here I transition from a red pen to a purple pen. It's not black, but it allows me to add more contrast to the sketch, punch things up, darken things out, make things read a little bit better. Form change equals value change. And so as I change the value, you read the form change better and better. I'm gonna use a little bit of ink that I've cannibalized out of an old pen. And I'm gonna put that on my finger and I'm gonna smudge that. It's gonna allow me to get some great gradations that are gonna be really tough to do with a marker. And I don't really like using pastels as it just gets everywhere. And I can do just the same thing by staying sort of in the ink world. You'll see I've put a big smudge on the right-hand side of the sketch across one of the petals. That's something that's gonna have to get fixed in Photoshop a little bit later. Here I use a 60% gray on the bottom of the petals. They're in shadow and they need to be darker to increase the contrast against the solar cell in the middle of the solar charger. I'm using an eraser just to sweeten up some of the transitions in the petals to increase their contrast and their read. You'll see I add very little value to the cell phone. It's not that important. It's just a reference in the sketch. Here I'm using a sweep just to sweeten up some of the curves. And now I'm coming in with a white jelly roll to increase the little highlights that you see on the edges of the petals, just to make things kind of pop, add little highlights here and there. I feel like the shadow underneath the device on the left-hand side needs to be punched up a little bit just to increase the contrast just a little bit here and there. And you'll see it kind of fades out over time, but it needs to have a little bit more darkness so I can increase the contrast and get a little bit better read. I think that really helps. I I add in the little lines that I'm going to make notes with digitally later on, so I do all my text digitally afterwards. I'm using a black pen for the very first time on all the really, really dark areas where I need to get that contrast and really pick up some of the detail in the dark, dark areas. And you can see that really helps the petals, punch them, give a little bit of contrast to get that light to dark. And I think it really helps make the sketch sing. Next, the image gets scanned in and edited digitally. Of course, the first thing I fix is that smudge on the petals on the right, that's gone. Next, I add in some text. So this is really what separates a sketch from a rendering, and what separates the big boys from the amateurs is adding notes onto your drawing. This allows anybody to understand what it is that they're looking at, even if you're not there to explain it. At least that's the idea. I also add in a logo that allows me to scale things. Ultimately, I really dislike the segmented hinges, and I change that. And digital is really great for making those kind of changes on the fly. I found that those segmented hinges were incredibly distracting, and I'm just going to make them big barrel hinges for the final design. That's the final rendering. It's time to go build a model. That's what we're going to do in the next episode. See you soon. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. I hope that you check out and enjoy some of the other videos that I have. Don't forget to like and subscribe.